And so now we'll come inside the standard widget and we'll remove that one, okay? Now here we're going to put a widget that is called sized off. Now for child itself, we are going to use over here, say flex, okay? Flex, all right. Allows us to put direction and what else? Now if you hover over on it, you will see that it takes a list of children, okay? So we want to put children, okay? Children, all right, great. Now a direction we can set it to axis dot horizontal. And why we are doing like this? So you need to take a look at the first picture over here. So these dots over here, they would be inside this flex widget, okay? Now, what would flex do? Because of flex, we can put a lot of children together. So they would be like a children one by one. Otherwise, you have to say a lot of them together, a lot of sized box. But here we are just using one sized box. But because we have flex, it would help us to do the layout for us one after another, because we are going to mention the direction of this, okay? So hopefully it makes sense. So here we are going to put list, okay? Now how to put the list? So, but we'll dynamically generate our list, okay? So here we do, list dot. Now say we want to generate five of them, and each of them, for example, we need to return them as a widget. Just want to simply return this dash, okay? All right, so now go ahead and save it. All right, so we already see them, it's over here, right? Okay, now we can change this one. How do you change this? So we do over here main axis alignment, okay? So here we do main axis alignment dot space between, all right? So you see, this one took the space uniformly, okay, and expanded to it. Now with this approach, there is a problem. So here, this part is pretty much fixed, right? And this is something that's also fixed, but that's fine though. But over here, we don't want to make it fixed. We want to make it dynamic, okay? Because larger screen and smaller screen, based on screen, you want to make them smaller and larger, things like that. As well as how many you generate. In larger scale, larger screen, you will have more dots. In smaller screen, you will have fewer dots, okay? All right, now because of this reason, let's go ahead and do layout builder. So we'll wrap it around the layout builder widget. So we do command enter or option enter. And here we do a widget and we'll call it layout builder, okay? Now why we are using layout builder? Because of layout builder, you will get the width of this space over here, okay? So you need to put it inside a parent. In our case, the parent is sized box, but we don't know what's the width of this parent, right? So in this case, if you put layout builder, we'll be able to grab that width, okay? That's why we wrap this flex using layout builder. So over here, it wants us to add this argument, and that's what we do. Okay, now it did it automatically for us, and over here you also see that it returns something. So instead of having this child over here like this, we'll move it inside layout builder and return it. All right, so now with this we'd be able to grab the width of this. And how to do that? So here we'll just simply print it. We do print the width is, so here we're going to use constraints dot constraints with width, okay? So this will give us the width, okay? Because layout builder has constraints, so it automatically calculates the width or height for you, okay? So we'll save it, and now if we come over here, you see that this is 69.333. So this is the distance that is 69.333. So that's the beautiful thing about it, okay? So as we can get it, so now we can apply it over here. So I'm going to copy this one and I'll remove this. First I'll put brackets and then inside it I'll put what I've copied and then I'll divide it by a certain number. So I'll divide it by 6. So what I'm telling, whatever this width is, take that width and divide it by 6, okay? Now, for a larger screen, you will have more numbers after the division. With smaller screens, you will have fewer numbers. That number represents the number of dots over here, okay? So here we will do 2 floor, okay, or floor. All right, so now let's go ahead and see. Okay, now that's what we have over here. Now to get rid of this problem, we'll maximize the space. So here we do main axis size, this one, and we do main axis size. So here we can use a sized box. And inside the size box, we'll have width. So here we'd mention width as 1, or maybe actually 3 is better. And height is 1, okay? Now we'll do a child inside this. So child, over here we'll do decorated box. And then inside this, we'll do decoration, and then we'll do box decoration, okay? And because of this one, we'd be able to apply color to it. The color, let's save it, and yes, the error is gone. Okay, so that's how you do it. So that was the first part of the puzzle. And then if you see the earlier design, we also need this arrow plane over here. Okay, so how to get that one? Now, we do have this one over here. And right after this, we have this thick container, which is this one. So right after it, first, we'll get an icon over here, okay? Now let's save it and see how it works. So it is there, okay? Now it is upward, but we want to rotate it. So how to rotate it? So we'll see how to rotate an icon. Here I'll cut this one, and over here we'll do transform.rotate, okay? This one. And then we need to specify the angle. So we do 1.5, so which is the from vertical to horizontal shift, which is more like 90 degrees, okay? Now we see that it converted like this. And after this, now what do we want to do? We are going to have to put it like this in the middle, okay? But right now we can't the way it is, okay? So the idea is this sized box and this one, they have to overlap. And how they are going to do it? So over here, we are going to put this sized box and transform widget together inside one special widget that's called stack widget, because stack widget helps you to have overlapping. Right now, they are not overlapping actually, okay? And you cannot really push it over here. But if you use stack widget, we'll be able to do that, okay? Now, for this reason, we need to move this one up and right next to it, okay? So that's what we are going to do. But first, what I'm going to do, I'm going to wrap it around size box, and then we are going to move it inside the stack widget. Sorry, I'll wrap it around using stack widget, then we'll move this one inside stack widget as well, okay? So I'll click over here, and then I'll do Option Enter, and then here there is a widget. And over here, I'll select the stack. So for this one, the parent widget is a stack widget, so we want to center it. So we'll select it with the center widget. Okay, well, let's save it, and it's centered. So that's how you do widget overlapping or cool design like this.